Hello viewers, today we are going to start with lesson 1, the snake bite, which is the first story of your course in secondary English. This story has been taken from the collection of stories, Life with Grandfather, written by the famous story writer Shankar Pillai. Now, before we go on to the story, let us ask ourselves some questions and find suitable answers to them. Have you ever seen a snake? Were you scared of him? Why? How would your parents react if one day you brought a snake or some other animal home? Have you ever visited a village? What is the general lifestyle of people living there? Do you find most people educated? Are there good hospitals and doctors? Imagine living in a village many years ago when most people were uneducated and there were hardly any facilities that we get to see in towns today. They had no doctors nor any hospitals. What could people do when someone was unwell or needed immediate first aid? They often went to weds or quacks, as we call them, who pretended to know how to cure most ailments. There were specialists who claimed they could remove poison from the body of a person bitten by a poisonous creature like snakes and scorpions, which are a common sight in remote villages. Another question that strikes us: how does illiteracy and ignorance become a bane? People in villages remain ignorant of most things, with the result they become easy targets for cunning people to fool them. They are vulnerable targets and are prone to becoming superstitious. Another question which comes to mind is this: are all snakes poisonous? No, they are not. But since most of us cannot differentiate between the poisonous from the non-poisonous, we tend to believe that all snakes are poisonous. Now, how do animals react when they sense danger? They either retreat into a safe hiding place or else attack in self-defense. What happens when you take decisions in panic? I'm sure you know we often tend to take wrong decisions. Now, this means that when there is an emergency, we must keep our heads on our shoulders and think clearly and rationally. Let's go through the gist of the story in short. This is a fascinating story about an orphan boy, Raja, who was brought up in a Kerala home by his grandparents. The story is told in first person. Raja was an orphan boy brought up by his grandparents, as I said just now. These grandparents doted on him and took extraordinary care of him. Raja, like any other boy of his age, was very naughty. He was fond of playing pranks and also loved playing with all sorts of insects and creatures. This habit of his often became a cause of worry for his grandparents. One day, he caught a snake and brought it to show his grandmother, who was aghast at seeing this. Another time, he was stung by a bee. He cried in pain and went to his grandmother for help. Before he could tell what happened, she concluded that it was a snake bite. The grandfather panicked. Without wasting any time, he rushed him to a snake doctor. Now let's read the story to find other interesting details. We are now going to read the lines. One day I saw a small snake, till were very dangerous. Raja was a young boy. He lived with his grandparents in a village. Raja was very naughty. He loved playing with all kinds of insects and animals. His grandparents were very concerned about his safety. One day, while playing in the compound, he happened to see a snake. He was excited. He quietly approached the snake. Seeing him come towards him, the snake retreated and hid in a small coconut shell that was lying there. Raja grew even more excited. He did not want to lose this opportunity. He at once covered the coconut shell with a big stone and carried the snake to his grandmother. When he saw his grandmother, he excitedly shouted, "Look, Grandma, I've got a snake." Grandmother, like all grandmothers, was terrified. She started screaming for help. On hearing her cries for help, the grandfather came running. When he was told that the narrator had brought a snake, grandfather quickly took the shell from his hand and threw it away. The snake slid away somewhere behind the bushes. The grandfather was so enraged that he warned his grandson in very strict tones, never ever to go near a snake. Now, let us analyze this part of the story. What are the main points? Children will be children. They often forget scoldings and warnings very soon. This is evident from the fact that the boy, despite his grandfather's warning again, tried to fiddle with a bee in the evening. What do you think of the grandson? Was he spoilt, naughty, fearless, or simply adventurous? The answer could be a mix of all. He was a pampered child and also naughty, fearless, and adventurous. I hope this part is clear. Let's go on to the next part, that is 1.2 of the story. Read the lines, later in the evening, till lived there. What is there in this part of the story? This part deals with something that happened in the evening and how the morning episode affected the decision of the grandparents. True to his nature, the narrator saw a bee and he wanted to catch it. But this time, he was not so lucky. The bee stung him on his finger. The narrator felt a sharp pain and went running to his grandmother again. He told her that he was bitten and requested her to do something to relieve him of the pain. He could not complete his sentence that he was bitten by a bee. The grandmother, in whose mind the snake episode was still fresh, immediately rushed to the conclusion that he must have been bitten by a snake. Once again, she shouted in panic, "Come and see what has happened to Raja." Hearing her panicky voice, the grandfather again rushed to the scene. He saw a blue mark on his finger. He too at once concluded that a snake must have bitten him. He did not ask any further questions, nor did he waste any time. He took the boy in his lap and raced through the fields. He stopped only when he reached a particular hut and shouted for the man who lived there. All this time, the boy could not understand what was happening. He looked confused and dazed. What made the grandparents think their grandson must have been bitten by a snake? Was something to think of. Were they right in thinking so? Why did the grandfather rush the boy in panic? What should he have done before rushing? Where do you think the grandfather took his grandson? Let's discuss the last part of the story. From the line, a grey-haired man came out of the house till grandfather sent him gifts. Who do you think was this grey-haired?